Note to self, try not to do flips near a river because somehow it may not work out. Duly noted. Funny thing happened on the way to the review farm. Took this out last weekend at the same location. We're at the tower right now. And as I started flying around, I just kind of started noticing things I didn't like about this. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna show you the old video and how it flew. It flew great out of the box. It was a nice little flyer. And then I'm gonna show you some things I did because, you know, upgrades. It is flight day for the Force One 220 FPV RTF. It's actually more like RTFER, which means ready to fly except the receiver. Tell you why in a second. Not sure what they were thinking, but they gave me this for a receiver. That would not be ideal. You can't put a square peg in a circle hole. It makes sense in China, I swear it does. I used to have it sit right here, but on every bump or everything, that propeller that used to be here would smack it, and it would just chew up that propeller. So we took it and we put it inside, and if I have a couple pictures, I'll put them here. But as you can see, I laid it on the board, put a couple pieces of foam padding and tape on it, and now we're good to go. We fit it under the hood, which is where you want to have that. You want to protect any kind of electronics you can by getting them under these hoods. When I put the antenna on the inside, I let the antenna dangle on the outside. Some people like to wrap it up inside here. I don't. I feel like this is better reception, at least circular, around the craft that's hanging down below, so it can go in any direction. I tied it up with a zip tie to keep it from going back up here. It won't reach either propeller, you can see, and we're safe there. We've got the Force One goggles that are tiny little goggles, but they have an adjustment for your eyes somewhere. Well, I thought they had an adjustment, they don't. We're gonna wing it. Let's take a look inside the goggles and see what you see. Now, the protective film is still on here, but that's okay. I don't wanna take them off because really they're relatively new, and why take it out if I'm not gonna use it probably. But you can see the camera works pretty well. It's a nice, clear, crisp screen, unlike other ones that I've had before. This one seems a lot better as it comes to lighting. It's a small, like 4 or 5 inch screen, has some magnification in it, and it comes with one battery, which you can slip on the side over here, and then watch yourself go, 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 like George Jetson, if you're into that kind of thing. One of the other things I don't particularly like is the fact that as much as I like that little chart there for where the channels are and stuff, when you put the battery on, it covers it, so you can't make a quick change. You gotta push that up, get over to your button, hold the button, and then go to your channel you wanna go to. The effort and strenuous amount of muscle movements I'd have to do then, my God, it's making me tired now. Good night. I replaced the antenna. This antenna is about a 3 dBi. The other one was supposedly a 5 dBi, but I don't think so. It didn't work like that, so I went ahead and got something a little bit better, more suited for this type of aircraft, because that's not gonna break. Last week the manual said, but still says it this week too, not like it changed overnight, some little, you know, user manual fairies came in and changed it. They didn't. But this said, when this item is powered on, let me power it on for you. When this item is powered on, see if you can see that or not, there is a red light by default that is in 25 milliwatts. You don't want that. You want this blue light, even though the manual says green light. Just put, I guess to get blue, to get green, you'd have to watch in yellow. Get yellow sunglasses, put them on, then that's green. Now with this antenna, we're gonna fly it around and see how the reception is. We're just gonna fly it out in the field. We could not go down past this tree down there. This tree right here. Am I pointing at it? I don't know, I can't see the screen. It's right there. One of those trees, you guys guess which one it is. And if that fails, I brought this with me. This is a air screw blue bean ultra from I'd Be Crazy, I think it is. And if I didn't mention, this is a SMA connection too, by the way. SMA connection, SMA connection. We'll put this on and we'll see if the video improves by flying the same route. I really, really hated the way these ESCs were on. So what I did, and you can see the picture here, Oh, look, my tape came off. What I did was I taped them up and I put a little protection on those. I took an old piece of a prop that I wasn't gonna use again and I taped it on the bottom here because the way the wiring is here, I would have had to unsolder everything, put it up, move it up to the top where I would prefer my ESCs to be. And that would have been taking like a long time and I didn't wanna do that with this. So in the meantime, this is what you should do. If you choose to get this, tape them up, get a little piece of a propeller or some kind of protective. You can use a piece of a Pepsi bottle is what Tampa FPV uses. And just put it on top, roll that tape around there and you're good to go. I just wanted to point out, I have some fashion sense too. This is actually practical. It reminds you what color nut goes over on that side. See, black, black, red, red, ha, 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 ha. But I'm a little bit intelligent. Next thing I did, I changed the propellers. The other propellers that came there were great, but I actually accidentally ordered these, or did I? These are 5051s. They've got a really severe super slant on them. I expect them to rip through the air like crazy and, you know, because we like that. I feel the need not to crash. But let's go get some shots of this flying. And then we'll get in the goggles and we'll fly around too. And then we're gonna go over to the trees and we'll fly around that too. We're just flying around everything. Cause I'm crazy like that. Here's my honest opinion. I love this thing. This thing flies great. I need a reset tune on it, but again, I was flying it pretty well as you saw throughout all the clips. Tampa FPV liked flying it. He really wanted to take it from me. He was grabby. He was being a grabby man. Note to self, when flying with a 4S battery, don't fly near the river because we dunked it. I don't know if you can see the water on there or not. We dunked it. Luckily, it is fresh water, and we'll just have to give it a day to dry out. But what happened was, and thank you Sierra Club for keeping the environment clean, they're the ones who came and rescued it. I took a flip, and I wanted to do a roll, and then I tried to do a tumble, and then for some reason, I'm not sure what happened, maybe auto leveling got in the way, and it just tumbled right out. And the last thing I heard was splash! But there's a benefit to this. Now we get to see how good and tough this thing really is, because it has now been splashed in the water, and we'll get to wait a day, replace some propellers, and let's see, what other one? Yeah, we have to replace that one. Replace the propellers, and then we're gonna put it up tomorrow because it should dry out by then, air dry. Now the nice thing is that is brackish water or fresh water and not salt water. Had it been salt water, that would have been a problem. The other benefit we had was the battery flew off before it went in. In fact, the battery was the only thing sitting in the tree. This thing was down on a ledge, and luckily this lady came by in a canoe and she grabbed it for me. Thank you, lady, whoever you are. So if you want to see what happened to this thing, hit that subscribe button. I do these reviews all the time, although I don't take them swimming with me. Okay, maybe in the bathtub. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Look, I just splashed this for you, man. All right, I didn't do it on purpose, but still. And if you want to leave your comments down below to see what happened to this thing. Will it come back to life or won't it? How about that run cam? Will that come back to life? Leave a comment down below and you tell me. Take your best guess. We'll find out tomorrow. Go ahead and share this with your friends and make sure you share the next video because that'll tell whether this comes back to life or not. Look, I got to jump to do this shot. From a beautiful place somewhere in the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida with a big white tower up behind me. Trying to figure out if this is ever going to come back to life again. This is the Mighty Thor.
See ya.